Hey Akshata, a podcast. Interesting proposition. But what, philosophy? Isn't that too brainy?
And that's the reaction of many novices. And admittedly, it was mine too.
You see, when I first started political philosophy, I thought, what is all this jargon? But after reading political philosophy for two semesters straight, I've realized there's nothing wrong with philosophy. What's wrong is that we haven't developed a tier of understanding. See, to make this podcast a hit, we have to do a few things differently. Think of baby food, for example. When a parent tries to feed their baby, the baby throws tantrums. Oh my God, why do I want this? I don't need this. I can survive till tomorrow. But the baby doesn't think about anything else. He just wants and acts on his whims. Well, think of the podcast and think of philosophy as baby food. Philosophy is baby food. The viewer is the baby, and the spoon is the podcast and us doing our job. Now, if you've ever seen or if you've ever had, you know, I'd say the fortunate experience or the unfortunate experience of having a kid, you'd realize that when you feed a kid, the kid throws tantrums. But when a parent goes, this is the food, and oh my God, this is the airplane, the kid laughs and then finally agrees to eat because it's distracted. Now see, I don't imply that our podcast has to be distracting, but our podcast has to be, and no pun intended, it has to be digestible to the common viewer.
But then, how do we make it digestible? How do we make it digestible? Well, I propose a two-step solution. Number one should be segmentation. Think about a Lego. By itself, it has good value, but when attached to something else, its value increases even more. That should be the entire perspective of a RealPolitik podcast. Let's take a prevalent issue. An issue such as Black Lives Matter, now more than ever, it has dominated industries of corporates, it has dominated entertainment, it has dominated every single industry we can think of. Well, as a RealPolitik podcast, what can we do? We would add political philosophical theories, but not just any political philosophical theories. Theories by MLK, his notes from Birmingham jail, which he took inspiration from Gandhi. We can talk about Gandhi and his political philosophies of ahimsa and satyagraha. See, political philosophies of ahimsa and satyagraha are timeless, but when attached to issues of today, the effect of the RealPolitik podcast would be out of bounds and it would be more impactful than the both of us can conceptualize. Secondly, we have to create a link. People think philosophy is just all Greek. They don't seem to comprehend it, and they much rather listen to someone speaking today and who's vociferous about today's issues, be it someone like Malcolm Gladwell. Therefore, we have to consciously make a decision to connect with not only with the present, but also with the past.
But more importantly, we have to break out of the mold. If you're viewing this video, you're probably viewing it on YouTube. And that's the direction I want to take the RealPolitik podcast. Sure, it's great to have the podcast within the JSR realm, representing not only our international affairs school, but also representing OP Jindal. But we want to hit a wider audience, an audience that's filled with amateurs, novices, and people much smarter than us. And the only way to achieve that is to go to YouTube and visualize our content. And trust me, if I can make a YouTube video, I'm very sure I can make a podcast as well.